Yep, I am a troll.
Well, I'm in my old neighborhood of East Vancouver. That's the east side of the city of Vancouver. Lots of memories of years spent around here. This is the old police station from the TV show Psych. And believe it or not, this old building, oh, and we got a boondocker here. This guy's been boondocking for years here. This old building plays the police department in Santa Barbara, of all places. Very unusual. Used to get very busy around here when they used to do the exterior shots. This is actually a popular boondocking area. I won't say where it is because I don't want to encourage more people to move in.
She's on the phone, but she's staying on. Well, Shop Boulevard, old dreams dying hard. It wants you to return its love.
Breathing in the dark. So, how's it going, guys? So, apparently, I have been labeled a troll, but I don't know how that can happen because all my troll videos, people know who I am. Hell, I've met dozens of nomads from YouTube all over the place. They know who I am. Many of them even have my phone number because there are no hiding in the shadows of darkness for me. But apparently I am a troll. Now, if I am a troll, then you guys are getting soft because I know what a real troll is, and we have to give respect to the real trolls because they hide and they don't do anything. They rarely even have any content. And if they do have content, it is attacking content and they never involve their personal face or name. No, 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 no. Haven't we all read the code of conduct for how to be a troll? Anywho, I think it's lame if people label me a troll because they obviously are really soft. They're buttery soft inside, and they have no freaking idea what a real troll is. And I think they should do a little bit of research rather than getting their little butt hurt about my opinions. Because if you get your butt hurt about my opinions, you're damn crazy. But apparently it's so easy to butt hurt people, especially those liberals that are so soft and gooey on the inside and need the safe zone. Oh yes, I warn them sometimes in the comments section that they shouldn't ask for my opinion about what they're talking about because I'm gonna hurt their feelings. Sometimes I have to euthanize people in the comments section. And what I mean by that is I make their comments go away because they're butt-hurting themselves after I've warned them that I'm actually gonna kick their butt with some bright metaphors. And that's about all I use as a weapon. I use some bright metaphors. That's it, folks. I know where the community standards lie, and I don't violate them. But some people, like I said, they just can't help themselves, and they're just so sensitive people. Oh yeah, they just get hurt so much about what I think and say. Oh boy. And if you get your butt hurt about what I think and say, you obviously do not have the strength and fortitude of your own convictions and your own personal identity. Because when you have that, you don't give a crap about what other people say or think. Unless, of course, you're Carolyn's RV life. Yeah, I had to throw that in. She hates it when I talk about her because she has no control over what I say. So I just love to poke, 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 poke. And mentioning her and how sensitive she is really still conforms to the community standards guidelines of YouTube. Yes, sirree, it does. So we're gonna cut it short here because I really don't want to butt hurt too many people and have them running to their safe zones and getting carpal tunnel syndrome from typing stupid comments towards me. Yeah, because I'd really hate that, you know, because the taxpayers are probably gonna pay for that carpal tunnel syndrome or something because they're gonna find a way to make you pay because that's the way the non-conservatives play. So in the meantime, folks, stay safe, keep your wheels on the ground. I'll talk to you soon. Over and out.